All right, here we go. This is round two between Maple Stage and Skyguard 777. And this time we are on Nestthorn. Last time we were on Salt. Definitely, I think those both of those maps are most suited. Both of those maps, this map and the last map, are both suited for 1v1. Mainly that's. I really, really would prefer just to see Nestthorn 1v1 and Salt just in 1v1 as well. Not necessarily that they can only be played in those games and that it's really a horrible experience in other modes, but at the very, very max, each of those maps is a 2v2 map. And we do have Maple Sage as the blue player in the upper left-hand corner in the Classic Osprey, and Skyguard 777, the red player in the bottom right-hand corner in the Steampunk Helix, exact same mechs and sides as last game. Pretty standard opening from Skyguard, but Maple Sage still going no Moneymaker and gonna be defending here with Flamers. He only has a lunchbox as his main, as his socket unit. There's nothing else that he has. And now Skyguard with a Flamer drop here. Maple Sage will be able to keep his outpost under his control with all the creeps that he actually has right now. But for how long? Will be able to take out some of the Flamers. Skyguard will definitely not be able to actually claim his outpost under his control. And now Maple Stage going to be grabbing more Flamers, going to retake that outpost. Oh man, Skyguard already back with some creeps. And will this be able to work? Will this work? No, Maple Stage gets his Flamers in first. And he will be able to hold this outpost for at least a little while. The creeps do go down. Skyguard actually real low on health. Maple Stage not pursuing that kill. Actually, I think he might have been able to get it, actually. And Maple Stage not bunkering those Flamers, but instead just stationing them down on the ground. I might advise against that. But instead he does have creeps in the bunkers, so those don't contribute to your unit cap. So maybe, you know, using bunkered creeps and defending Flamers is a good idea, especially because Flamers do have AoE, so they will be able to attack multiple infantry if we do have an infantry drop, which is insanely common in today's meta level game. And Maple Stage healing up a Flamer! Man, it's really, really rare to see an Osprey healing up an infantry, especially if it's not, Ospreys heal infantry sometimes when they're trying to keep them alive for an outpost drop or cheese or something like that. But to heal a Flamer defensively is just something to see. Just like that, you see Maple Sage heal this Flamer to keep it alive, just try to get that outpost neutralized a little bit and try to keep that damage going down for a little longer. And Skyguard getting that kill on Maple Stage, actually the Seeker getting that final kill, but now Maple Stage not on the field for a little while, and Skyguard with Longhorn a little bit hesitant, didn't drop it at that forward outpost, but now decides to go with a forward drop. But Maple Stage with that lunchbox in a 1v1, it's really, definitely really uncommon to see. And Skyguard getting shut down completely. None of those shots got through the lunchbox shield. Yeah, the cumulative effect of those shots, I guess I should say. But now Skyguard positioning. No, not going to position that Longhorn defensively. Going to start creating a unit cluster there, I guess preventing Maple Stage's creeps, or at least a lot of them, from getting past and getting to that middle outpost. Maple Stage now with a lot of tanks at this mid on the left side. And Skyguard with a Gatti. Okay, putting the Gatti on the corner instead. I guess that's a good... Oh, he sent this one out? That's a little strange. Not really sure what's with that send. Maybe that was just a little bit of a miss micro because he did set it on Y. I think that was the same Longhorn that he brought back from that fort attack. So it was still set on attack. But now it does have it on hold. He has quite a large tank cluster. And one tactic I really do like seeing on Nestthorn. Nestthorn, kind of one of the only maps that this actually works on, just because it's the only map that the configuration actually suits it, is doing a gap jump after setting them on either capture or attack, and just dropping them and carrying them over this gap right here to the enemy close, and does work on the other side as well. And now we do have Skyguard with a tank push. Will he go for the mid, or will he do the gap jump? We are yet to see that. I don't know. He is a Helix, so he can support the, you know, carrying and ferrying back and forth. However, he's just level 3, which will not get him a double Longhorn carry. And does decide to drop that Longhorn on this... Oh, not on the corner, but on the side. Puts it on that platform, and these Longhorn are going for this mid. Only 3 Longhorn defending force, and that Longhorn does, that Longhorn drop does force Maple Stage back to the fort, which will allow Skyguard a lot of time here by himself to try to kill what he can. Oh, Maple Sage desperately trying to get the block, but really, really needs to get back to his mid fight. Does go down to neutral. He's not going to be able to bring out any more units. He only had Fixers in his queue anyway, just a single Longhorn, but it was mostly Fixers. And Skyguard going to be able to get a surround on this. I'm pretty sure those Longhorn are going to be able to actually do the job. There's a lot of Seekers as well, not gonna let Maple Stage kind of sit in that area and support his units with Micro. And now Skyguard will be able to get this. I'm a little confused as to why these just stopped. Maybe Skyguard set them on hold position after they got there. I didn't really catch that, but for either way, those Longhorn. Oh, well, I mean, Skyguard now has this middle outpost, so he will have a lot of time to start repositioning. We'll be able to bring down even more tanks to fortify this mid. I mean, Maple Stage can do a quick scout, see that there's just a secret defending over here. Absolutely nothing defending Skyguard's fort over there. And this right outpost as well, right forward, has nothing defending. There's just that Gaddy sitting over there. And what will Maple Stage do now? He will probably go for, yes, he does go for the corner. And Skyguard not really coming back to respond to this, just really wants to prioritize, and holding that mid does allow Maple Stage to kill one Moneymaker, and that Longhorn still raining down. Well, not raining, it's just firing forward, but so I guess raining forward down. Okay, that's just a horrible adaptation of that phrase. But Maple Stage going down. Longhorn still doing a little bit of damage, but now is getting blocked by Skyguard's Longhorn. Doesn't need to just... That's definitely not necessary. He had two Longhorn in the area, one blocking, one on the back. Did not need to spend the extra few seconds to just land and shoot there. Could have spent it on doing a little bit more repositioning in mid, doing a quick scout of Maple Stage's side. But now does have a... that artillery is within Skyguard's range of both fire and rockets, and does get finished off. Maple Stage with a single heavy mine. I guess that is just in anticipation of Skyguard pushing out, but, you know, one of the easiest ways to, and probably the most common way to counter a heavy mine, is just straight up run over it. And Skyguard will eventually be able to detect, yes, there are some units there. Those dots on the minimap are not invisible, so he could actually push up, but I don't know if he can actually deny this. And Maple Sage with another Longhorn. Let's see if he can actually get it. Oh, does not manage to drop it on the corner. Does have to just... Oh, Maple Stage going down once again. Gonna lose another Longhorn. Skyguard gonna be able to finish off this Longhorn. Once again, does not have to stay there as long as he actually did. There was actually a Gaddy shooting the back of that Longhorn, which does actually terribly good damage. And Maple Stage says, I'm stuck? Oh, he can't move? I don't know. Okay. Okay, no, apparently he can move. Never mind. Oh, illusion of bugs. It's hilarious, I think, that Aramech has so many bugs here and there that sometimes when something weird happens, or if you're just derping out, you might actually mistake it for a bug. And we do have Skyguard pushing out his tanks. Going to be able to finish off this tank cluster if Maple Stage does not retreat them back. And now he does notice it. Will start to pull his tanks back. Will he be able to survive? One Longhorn did go down, but one Seeker and one Longhorn were brought out from that cluster. So he was able to save two out of three of those units. And now what will Maple Stage decide to do? It's kind of a normal Nestorm fight where Skyguard is kind of turtled mid. And now it does have two Longhorn on the side. Will Maple Stage be able to save this in time? Does have a Buster out or in his build queue. So we'll try to get this from the front. Okay, does decide to body block. Will give Skyguard a lot of time. Does put a Sonya down. But I guess in anticipation of Maple Stage putting up another artillery. But it's not that dangerous. Skyguard now with a tech pot out. Or at least coming out. Okay, now did drop it somewhere. Okay, behind that mid. Probably a good decision, seeing as the mid is insanely turtled up. And now Maple Stage has to deal with this Longhorn cluster that Skyguard has brought over. And will be able to drop a Longhorn. I don't think he'll be able to hold this outpost, or not at least hold it, but at least keep it under his control. It will probably go down to neutral as Skyguard is really, really prioritizing and focusing on that. However, Maple Stage actually able to keep a lot of his tanks alive. And Skyguard, oh, might have actually been better off just going for a fort drop. Yeah, seeing as he can carry two Longhorn now, it would be really, really effective to do that. And Maple Stage now trying to keep his Longhorn alive, trying to reposition and micro them around. But Skyguard with quite a lot of tanks in the area already. Longhorn versus Longhorn action. And we'd have Maple Stage with a Buster. We'll be able to keep it alive with his heal, so let's see how much progress he can actually do. Oh, but we do have tanks being dropped behind the Buster. The Buster taking so long to reposition itself, but Maple Stage with that heal Oh, one Longhorn already has gone down. Let's see if Maple Sage can hold out. He's actually doing a pretty good job, I would say, but Skyguard with even more tanks coming out. Oh, Maple Sage did get killed by... Oh, Skyguard has fine Longhorn. He has fine Longhorn in his loadout, which do a little bit more damage, have a little bit more health, but cost quite a lot more. I think it's like 50% more, something a little bit ridiculous. I don't exactly know. That might have been the old value, but yeah, it's just a little bit stronger and a little bit more tanky for a lot more credits. Definitely something you have to go full moneymaker for. So it wasn't Longhorn versus Longhorn a little while ago. It was Longhorn versus slightly stronger Longhorn. And Maple Stage not able to hold that close outpost. Oh man, and Skyguard moving out already. Let's see if Maple Stage can hold this off. Oh, I don't know. He already has that close. All the focus is going to be on the close. Skyguard can actually even send from this close, do a lot of damage while this push over here is making its way toward this forward. However, I think this line of Longhorn will be able to hold for Maple Stage, and Skyguard, yes, is pushing out. Oh man, I don't know. Okay, yeah, they will reach the tank lines about the same time, but Skyguard does need to do a lot of micro to be able to hold this, or to be able to make this a worthwhile. Just put it, I don't know about that. Maybe on the platform on the sides would have been better. Oh, and Maple Sage actually went down to one of those Seekers. These Longhorn are kind of just getting shredded up by this line, this defensive line right here. But a lot of them have made it through. Skyguard sent almost everything at the mid, though. So if this doesn't work, if this does not get the finish for Skyguard, I don't know how well he'll be able to hold up at that mid. However, a lot of the units from Maple Stage are going down as well. The two tank pushes did not reach this fort at the same time, for sure. Skyguard really needs to start getting more repositioned. Might want to drop more on the sides as well. The better surround you have, the better, I would say. Even though, I mean, he's not even trying to go for the corners at this point. I'm not exactly sure why. I mean, the only real reason I could assume is that he's not aware that the corners do double damage. But I know Skyguard is a very, very experienced player, so I would once again assume that he is familiar with that mechanic. However, the majority of his tanks are dead, and Maple Stage able to hold out for a pretty long time. He's out of Fort Energy, 100% out of Fort Energy. I really do wish the Fort either had infinite energy or, like, I don't know, quadruple or triple or something, the amount of energy that it currently does have. That is, as it is, your absolute last stand. Maple Stage getting killed again by a Seeker. But Skyguard has not been able to get the finish on Maple Stage at this point, and actually the upkeep values have pretty much evened out. It is 22 to 26. Granted, Skyguard has a lot of fine Longhorn on the ground as opposed to Maple Stage's normal Longhorn, I'm pretty sure. Let's see if my tool tips will actually work. Nope, but I would guess that Maple Stage has normal Longhorn and not fine Longhorn, but oh, is sending out a push. Is he sending this on T, and if he is, will he do a gap jump? And if he doesn't do a gap jump, will he be able to get that fort, that middle outpost under his control, seeing as Skyguard sent practically everything during that last push? Oh wow, Skyguard making moneymakers. Not necessarily something you see very typically, especially if even, I mean, a lot of, the, you know, on Nestorn, you know, the enemy taking that close is a fairly common occurrence. However, you don't really see that many people that do that start to support their, or not support, but start to socket moneymakers to gain them more an extra advantage, because those moneymakers are pretty much sitting in on the front lines, and for the most part would get killed very, very quickly. Did Skyguard count them? I guess so, because he only has 8 moneymakers out on the field, which is 3 plus 3 plus 2. That is full of socketed moneymakers on your side of the map. Skyguard desperately trying to stay alive here. Maple Stage gonna be able to get the. I think he's gonna completely win this battle. Skyguard bringing another Longhorn here, of another fine Longhorn, but I don't know how long he can actually survive here. Maple Stage now coming back to the fight with a Fixer and a Longhorn, spamming alternately, not necessarily spamming, but building alternately healing units and Longhorn, which is pretty effective for the most part. When I was a newer player, I tended to go one healer for two tanks, and it's pretty good. You know, it's not great. You know, there's definitely optimal unit cluster, you know, compositions, especially because you have to consider what kinds of unit compositions you're playing against. But you know, healing and attacking, you know, straight up tanks and healing units is a pretty effective and very robust combination against general play styles. And now Skyguard is actually behind, not in the upkeep, because he does have that close outpost, which I think it's kind of a mistake for him to completely ignore. Oh, Maple Stage not able to get that second Longhorn down, and does drop the awe one more time. And Skyguard again, going to really make sure this Longhorn is dead, but with three Longhorns sitting there for defense, you definitely don't have to do that. And does have three Longhorn now defending his fort. But Maple Stage coming back to the fight. And will be able to get an okay surround on this outpost. Skyguard, okay, does once again remember that he has that close outpost under his control, but still really, really focused on what Maple Stage has, and instead of what he has, I guess on what he does not have as opposed to what he does have. And Maple Stage gonna get a reposition of that Longhorn, gonna go for the corner, gonna get a little bit more fire in, and probably gonna be able to hold it and keep it alive for, oh no, retreating it, pulling it back. I don't know if that's a good decision, but it's definitely a safe decision. Probably a smart decision, just because he, you know, did a little bit of damage. You know, once again, Skyguard does not have a lunchbox, so every single shot is permanent. I guess the way you can think about it is there is a fixed amount of shots that a Longhorn has to shoot in to actually finish off the opponent, and he's just working his way up to that final number. And now doing a little bit of harass, not really effective at all, but does keep Skyguard on his side of the of that gap versus trying to attack mid or trying to scout there. But now Maple Stage again trying to go with a moneymaker kill with that Longhorn. Oh, really, really dangerous, getting finished off with that Seeker. Maple Stage getting killed one more time, dropping the LOL. Skyguard going to be able to finish this off. Really doesn't have to, as he has two Longhorn defending at his fort. So once again, don't need to spend all that time shooting yourself. Not shooting yourself, like literally pointing your gun at yourself. Shooting, but shooting with your own mech. Wow, sometimes I just jerk my own brain. But Maple Stage now going to be ill. Well, I mean, outpost got neutralized, but Maple Stage just has to do a quick trip over to... Okay, now Skyguard kind of shifting his focus to this close. I mean, yeah, you don't really have to spend that much time defending your forward, as, you know, Nestorn, it takes forever for that push to arrive and, you know, defender's advantage. So focus on the advantages that you have, and not necessarily that the advantage that the opponent has. And Maple Stage actually really low on health. Gonna be finished off here. No, does get back to that top, but it's still really low on health, and Skyguard might be finished off instead. Oh, and the Hunter Seeker missile follows him across the gap. Maple Stage again dropping the LOL, definitely having a lot of fun playing this game, which is what I would like to see. And Maple Stage with two Longhorn, interestingly enough, going for behind these Longhorn. Gonna try to kill what he can. Might want to just start flying in circles and healing. And Skyguard now coming back to the fight with some level 4 creeps. Both of those Longhorn were finished up. Maple Stage not able to come back to save them. And might overextend himself just now, right now. Not getting killed, though. Not getting killed. Kind of something that is happening over and over and over again in this game, in this match. But now putting an artillery down on Skyguard's side, defending it with some Longhorn and getting some heal, but definitely needs some Seekers, okay? Good, nice varied. Oh, and Skyguard gonna push out here, including his goalies. But I don't know, this defensive, oh, and Maple Stage pulling back. He might have been able to hold off, or at least do a pretty good trade. And, you know, for the amount of time it takes for Skyguard to get his units from this right side all the way around this lane to mid, It might have been worth it for Maple Stage just to try to kill what he could. But now Skyguard actually ferrying some stuff over the ledge. Oh, he already has the ultimate. Yes, he does have the ultimate. Oh, he even has level 1 build speed. I was about to say build. Bead spilled, which is battle exchange. But build speed ability. And now starting to ferry his units over this gap, doing a mass hold position, which is definitely something that's really, really awesome in combination with that tactic. But now Maple Stage just like, okay. This forward outpost is... Oh man, is this going to be a base race? Skyguard has a lot of his tanks now moving out, and there is not that much defending for Maple Stage. Where is Maple Stage? Where is he going to go from here? Oh, he's actually already sent out from his mid, but Skyguard is way closer than Maple Stage. But the big difference here is that Maple Stage has a defense here at this fort, but Skyguard pretty much does not. But it'll take a long freaking time for those tanks to actually reach Skyguard's fort, and I don't think that Maple Stage is going to be able to hold out here. Lots of damage going down on Maple Stage's fort, and this still would have been another, I don't know, 15 to 20 seconds at least before it actually got there. So Skyguard taking round two, it is even 1-1. I don't have a game three for you guys, but I will probably request Maple Stage and Skyguard to close out this series. Definitely would like to see that. Love best of threes. I gotta admit, guys, if you send me a best of three and it is high quality, we'll probably have a higher chance of me actually using them. So keep that in mind. Maple Stage asking Skyguard permission to share it. And to be honest, you don't need permission, guys. You don't need permission. This is not some sort of personal property, okay? You play the game. The replay is owned by you, regardless of who played in the game. So if you have any games, best of threes or not, guys, send it to me. Make sure to send it to ruy0x@gmail.com. And I'm definitely available on Steam as well. I'm always in the AirMech chat room, guys. I don't know why no one joins that more. I guess because after the advent of global chat, it's like, who needs to join the AirMech Steam chat anymore? But to be honest, global chat's a freaking mess. I barely ever pay attention to that thing. And no one goes in AirMech Steam chat anymore. But anytime someone does and says something, I read it. Because it's not super cluttered like freaking global chat. But anyway, that's sort of beside the point. Make sure to send your replays into me, especially if you play or spectate any great ones. So lastly, this is RUY. And that is game. See you next time.